Is there any effort on the part of your team to secure this money through another country, Saudi Arabia or Russia, as Joy Behar seems to think?
Well, that was pretty direct. That was Fox News anchor Martha MacCallum coming in hot with these questions to Trump's lawyer Alina Habba, as we are just days away from the time when Trump has to pony up this $464 million, which includes that appeal money of Judge Engoron's decision in his New York civil fraud case. And he is, oh man, are you guys getting texts? I mean, the pre-roll ads are just churning for my man. I don't wonder how that that GoFundMe is doing. He doesn't have the money. No insurance companies will lend him the money. And so a natural question that I guess Joy Behar had, and not a bad point. Take a look.
But is Letitia James gonna go like put a chain on Trump Tower?
Yeah,
and take it
like
away
that
from him?
She said that
he doesn't have the money. Nobody wants to lend him the money in this country anyway. Who knows what's going to happen with Russia and Saudi Arabia? Because they know that he doesn't pay his bills back, and obviously he didn't make enough money in that golden sneaker thing.
Right, and it would be a boot on Trump Tower, not a chain. But how did Alina Habba respond? Obviously, no, right? That's un-American. America first, right? No? Isn't it no?
Well, there's rules and regulations that are public. I can't speak about strategy that requires certain things, and we have to follow those rules. Like I said, this is manifest injustice. It is impossible. It's an impossibility. I believe they knew that. I think that's why mid-trial, frankly, they changed their ask from $250 million to the ridiculous amount of money that they've asked for. I think everything is done intentionally. I do not doubt that the witch hunt, that the election interference goal is what was ringing steady and loudly and true throughout all these trials, frankly. And we're seeing it. It's the demise of our country, not the demise of Trump. So we'll handle it as we always have and keep our heads up and keep working hard.
I mean, we'll be fine without him. It's okay, Alina. It's okay. It's okay. He can go into demise. But wait, what was the answer there? Is he trying to get money from abroad? Well, there's rules and regulations, and so we're looking into that. That's not a no. I'm not hearing a no. Before I kick it to you, Jake, what was the follow-up here that Marsha had? Let's look.
Keep working hard.
Okay, keep us posted on the effort. We look forward to speaking with you again. Thank you very much, Alina Habba, joining
us
today.
Wait, what? I actually thought there was a follow-up, so that was a fun little trick the producers played on me. You just left it there. I'm sorry, we're out of time. You're gonna get Saudi money? Cool. Moving on. Cenk, you know, I have to say, this hadn't occurred to me after all the billionaires all week have been like, I don't want you, I don't want you, that, yeah, he might just beg for it from abroad. But
yeah,
Alina Habba's not dissuading that idea.
A lot of mainstream media don't give you honest news. We do, you know why? Because of you. Paid membership on YouTube makes all the difference. Hit the join button below and you become the hero that sustains us.
No, that was hilarious. So Martha MacCallum says, Joy Behar has this ridiculous conspiracy theory about how you guys might get it from abroad. So what do you say? Well, we're looking into it. And then I thought for sure then Martha was gonna come back with, wait, did you say you're looking into it? That you might actually take money from the Saudis? But then you're running for president. Wouldn't he be beholden to the Saudis? Instead, she goes, oh, wow, Alina Habba, thank you for coming out. Appreciate it. To which I thought, Martha. So, guys, are they looking into taking foreign money to pay it off? And then will Donald Trump owe a debt to a foreign country? And if he's president, will he help that country? Of course! Of course. Her answer was super clear. Look, again, if you're MAGA, even you know that answer was super clear. Yes, they're looking into taking foreign money. Remember, your movement is called America First. And even if you're the deepest MAGA dude, you know that Trump is gonna serve the money. There is no scenario where Trump takes the money and goes, well, I don't really care about people who give me money. I'm going to be principled anyway. No one's MAGA enough to believe that. And if you think about it, one of the countries mentioned was Saudi Arabia. And what has happened with Saudi Arabia? Well, Donald Trump, after the leader of Saudi Arabia dismembered an American journalist, Donald Trump said free to go. And there was no consequences at all. And he said, what? I like their money. Mm-hmm. And so, and by the way, there's credible reporting that Jared Kushner might have given up our sources in Saudi Arabia, some of whom got arrested and tortured, and some died. Now, I don't know for sure that Jared Kushner did that, but by God, there should be a hell of a lot more investigation about that. And guess what Jared Kushner got right after the election? $2 billion from the Saudis to invest in his equity company. And so
you don't know if he did that or not, Cenk, but just hang on. Wouldn't he? He is like, imagine you're Jared Kushner. You have literally no soul. You don't have mirrors in your home. You don't care who dies so long as you get rich. Like, truly, that is the least stretch of possibility. Like, anyway, keep going because that's not the point. But
look, guys, I'll tell you what we do know. Jared Kushner went to personally visit the crown prince, Mohammed bin Salman, the butcher of Riyadh. And then, right after Kushner's visit, Mohammed bin Salman arrested people he perceived to be his political enemies within the Saudi royals. He imprisoned some of them, he tortured some of them, and he killed some of them. Then there was a report out that people were in the intelligence community were concerned that Kushner had given up some of those names. And then, by the way, he comes back and this intelligence community says, pull a security clearance. You remember when they had this huge fight over pulling Jared Kushner's security clearance? Gee, I wonder why they wanted to pull it. And then right after the election, he gets $2 billion. Okay, maybe it's a coincidence. They'll have to prove it in court if it ever happened. But is it ever gonna go to court? No, the elites are above the law. And so it's an outrage that there isn't an investigation in Jared Kushner to see whether he did or did not do that action. An unbelievable outrage. And Jamie Raskin asked for the committee investigating sons of presidents to investigate Jared Kushner yesterday. And the Republicans were like, no way. We care about Hunter Biden's $5 million, but we don't care about Jared Kushner's $2 billion. From a foreign government. By the way, Jared Kushner is one of the worst businessmen in American history. He literally did the worst real estate deal in history of the United States of America. You can look it up, it's called 666 Fifth Avenue. And he nearly bankrupted his entire family with that. And the Saudis were gonna give the worst investor in America $2 billion out of the goodness of their hearts. So my point is, at this point, is Trump looking to kiss more Saudi ass and go across the world going, please pay my bills. I was pretending to be a billionaire, but now I'm caught. I'll do anything for you when I'm president. I'll give up our sources, I'll let you kill people, I'll let you dismember people. I'll do anything for you, fundamentalist dictators, etc. Just pay my bills. That's what that bitch is doing right now. America first, my ass.
I think it might be China. We know he got $5.5 million while he was in office. Another thing Jamie Raskin has helped us understand, they are so corrupt and absolutely soaked in foreign money. It's ridiculous. But yeah, let the bidding begin. TikTok till Monday. I'm very excited to see where this goes.
Yeah, I mean, to your point, Franny, there, our politics is already so corrupt. Overwhelmingly saturated with legalized bribes to the tune of billions of dollars. Now, presidential candidates are doing open auctions with foreign governments as to who's going to purchase their loyalty. This is disgusting. Does this look like democracy to you guys? This is the height of corruption. And this guy said he was gonna drain the swamp. Right now, he's swimming in a Saudi swamp as we speak. And by the way, it's not just Jared Kushner. What did Donald Trump get? What is the one business deal he got after he left the White House?
The golf tournaments.
Right. All of the golf tournaments were moved to Trump properties by the Saudis who had bought the golf tournaments. Huh. Mm-hmm. I'm sure another wild coincidence. Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.